Now, when you perform a battery load test, heavy equipment often uses multiple batteries. They need to be disconnected. You cannot test two batteries at once. They need to be tested individually. For the sake of this test, you most likely will test a battery removed from the machine already and located on the bench. So we're going to test this battery here. You'll notice that it has threaded terminals on the top. When you attach a load tester, such as this VAT45, you need to install an adapter so that you will get good contact. So we need to install these threaded nuts on here. Make sure they go all the way down and contact the bottom of the terminal. That's going to allow less resistance and impedance to the testing and give it good amperage flow, so the battery has a good chance of passing the test. The machine is powered by the battery, so we're going to attach the leads. Remember, the red will attach to the positive, black to the negative. And you'll notice that the machine will now power on. It goes through a little bit of a self-test. And we will then see our voltage of the battery. Hopefully you recall that for a 12-volt battery, a 12-volt battery is fully charged when it's at 12.6 volts. Before we can perform a load test, though, we need at least 75% charge, or 12.4 volts. Here you'll see that our battery already reads at 12.65, so we're in good shape there. We're doing a battery load test, so we're going to need to measure the amps using the amps probe like we have here. You want to make sure the amps reading is zero. It might flash between 0 and 1 or 0 and -1. That's okay. That would be considered zero. And you then want to take it and clamp it on the positive cable going back to the machine. It does have a small arrow on here, if you can see that arrow. And you want that facing in the direction of current flow from positive to negative. So in this case, we want the arrow pointing back towards the machine. This clamps around the cable and will measure any magnetic fields to measure the amperage. It might slide down to the ground, but it'll be fine there. Be careful not to break that amps lead. It's very important and not a cheap component. This battery, to begin a load test, we need to know the cold cranking amps. And on the label, we can see that it's clearly rated at 925 CCA. In the user manual for our machine, you can open up to the section on battery testing, and you'll see that we have two scales here. If it was under 450 CCA, we would be able to dial in the half the cold cranking amps and test to that for 15 seconds. This has a limited load. It will only do a load of 225 amps on this machine. So for batteries over the 450, you match up the CCA size and the load time. So if we follow this chart down, you can find that chart in the manual. You'll see that the 925 is off the bottom of the chart, so it would say we'd want to load to 45 seconds. 45 seconds would be our load time, and we would use the maximum load of 225 amps. So we're going to proceed with that. Now remember, on this machine, it does do an automatic battery test. That is not what we want to do. It's an efficient test, but we really don't know what's going on. The machine's doing the work. The machine's making the judgments. We want to use the manual test so that we, as a technician, can make the decisions, especially during the NOCTI. Some of the information you need to write down is only available through the manual test. So we'll go to options. We'll use the scroll wheel. It's already on manual test. We'll click yes. And now it has us dial in our load. It was already at 225. You can see I ran it down to 125. We'll go back up to a fixed load of 225. That's correct. And now we have to dial in our load time. It's currently at 5 seconds, and we will run that up to 45 seconds. Okay. So now we're set. We're going to hit yes for start, and that'll begin our load test. You can see already we have amps reading. During the load test, we are monitoring our voltage. That is going to be what tells us if this battery passes or fails. If the battery is at room temperature, which most of the times we're testing things, they are, we're looking for it to stay above a voltage of 9.6 volts. That will be a good battery. So we have 24 seconds to go. We're at 11.3 volts right now. At the end of this 45 seconds, it will freeze the voltage so that we can see what we're reading. You'll notice that our load is looks like 213 is what we're reading when we're set on that fixed load of 225. So just a little bit more. That completes our test. You notice that it jumped back to reading live voltage on the top here, but down below you can see it says our end amperage was 211 amps and our end voltage was 11.3 volts. That's well above the 9.6 volts that would be the threshold for a pass or fail battery. So this battery tests good. We definitely want to record our load, our amount of seconds it was applied for, as well as our end voltage. Sometimes when you're testing a battery, you'll want to see the recovery voltage come back up within basically a tenth of a volt or so of where you started. So it looks like this is coming up. We're already back up at 2.47, almost 2.5 volts. And that is how you perform the battery load test.